left, forward and left.
Forward and left.
Can we get through? How do we get through?
I don't think you can. I'm pretty sure it should be up here.
No, down there. It's public viewing area, you moron.
Oh, thanks. You don't need to call me next. I'm not looking at the map, am I?
Do we have to go around? Go left and go. We might have to go around. Hurry up, Phil, go. Go, go left.
Hey,
we have to go all the way around there, so
okay.
You have to go faster or we're going to miss the start.
Alright.
Careful, on the grass, careful. Don't go too fast on the grass.
No, you're not.
Because you'll hit a pothole and then bang, I'll go flying. That's when we get there. No, we'll lay the picnic blanket out. You're getting your work done today, aren't you?
Yeah, oh yeah.
Look out. Seriously?
Oh.
How did you manage that?
Because I'm a dream.
Well,
sorry, right. It's okay, thank you.
You're
right. I got it, thank you.
I told ya. What did I tell ya? You'll be back in here with the same bottom line.
You know,
yeah.
If it weren't for my amazing personality right now, who would be so nice? I like that so much.
Well, that's why I bought the ibuprofen.
Oh, yeah, good point.
We don't need a wristband, do we?
Huh?
I'm pretty sure it's only if you intend to leave and come back. Go. Quick tool. They've even got porters, so we don't know how much place there's in there.
We are doing great. How would you like
to a nice spot, closest to the runway. Although we might be better on the upper part of the hill, actually.
I'm good with finding a place to shade.
There's no shade.
Oh well, I'll just burn, that's fine. Worth it, right?
Well, you can put the blanket over you.
No, thank you.
You partly fold it and you hang it over your head.
No, thank you.
That's why the hats are important. Go. Careful. Am I that heavy? Careful. Okay, don't go too fast, sorry.
Yeah, it's uneven surface. We were a bump.
We could sit up there, but I think I want to be closer.
Oh.
This is pretty even. They're going to be hearing that comments from me barking orders and you dying behind me. Your legs falling off behind me. Careful down here. Careful, this is major loot. Nice.
How do you not want to hear any crap?
Oh, well, okay. Whoa, we're laughing down there.
Alright,
let's find a nice spot. I prefer to be upper on the hill.
Oh.
Well, what are your thoughts?
Okay.
Do these belong to everyone?
Oh.
Oh, they love edging for them or something. Someone brought a tent.
Alright. We'll go over there.
Alright. Oh sure, I kind of would rather be on the hill. Yeah, I think we should be on the hill.
Here if you want.
No.
Alright, where is that going?
Go down on that side maybe. Because they're going to be up in the sky from here, so go down there.
I should.
The 2023 Australian International Air Show is ready for takeoff. Your aerospace compass has brought you to this point today. Look to the
over
right.
There?
I'm joined by co-compere Tony Moclair.
Great to be here, Peter, and yes, to the right you will see.
Oh my gosh, sorry. You're going to have to go up. Go up.
Opening the air show.
For today,
Sunday.
Oh, can you walk up? Can
you walk up? We probably look like it. We're like the beginning show. Watch this little show trying to go across the sky.
A display of our national flag. A very sunny day today, top temperature 32, very little humidity.
Do you want to go backwards? Do you want to go backwards?
You can make it.
Check it out.
And it's all gone. Oh, yeah.
Right.
I'm happy for it.
I'm happy for it. Let's go. All right, up in the hole over there.
How do you
select
this way?
Can you? I'll fake a limb. So, I'll fake a limb. Australians were custom-made to stand.
Hey then.
Well, let's go up and see. Is there a spot opening up the front?
You're tripping. No.
Well, we'll go a bit up the road. Well.
At an aerospace event in Australia. Tony Beauclair is on commentary today with me, and Tony, what a day we have in store today.
I don't want to block
with
anyone else
here. With the wheel track.
With the wheel track.
Because you can begin it. Wheel track, let's go. Oh, this is nice. But do you want to go over there or no? Okay. Yeah?
We've got the ATF showcase, which is very exciting. All the assets, especially
someone's bunkers there, though.
You can sit here.
Well, we can't take up someone's bunker spot.
If they were going to sit there, they
could. The Romeo, plus the Americans here with the F-22 Raptor.
Yes, you'll leave here today marveling at what we have in store for you today. Commentary today, Tony Moclair, Angela Stevenson, Grant McCarran, Adam Maloney on audio, and our systems today, the audio system presented by Clear Systems. I'm Peter Mayer. We hope you have a terrific day today, very enjoyable day. A hallmark event is... gathering growth. Now, 2 minutes to the parachute drop. Tony, this guy is absolutely perfect for parachutists, but I understand wins a lot of room and steam.
So we may not see one of the features of the parachute drop, which is flags, but they're intrepid bunch. They will jump out of a perfectly good aeroplane, which in this case is a turbo-powered T-Hatland Beaver. It's an active aircraft. No seats at all on it. It's built for taking people one way. And
save that charge, though, Saul.
Peter, before with a parachute. Exactly, that's the important thing. Make sure you've got one on your back.
So turn the brightness down a little bit until bearable.
And
turn the screen off mainly.
Please take any
there's no service out here.
Really?
Oh. So I can get that messages, but I can't get them.
That doesn't make sense.
You want to keep the danger of any foreign object debris to an absolute minimum so that the runway
Open the ships.
Straight piece of rubbish and put it onto the active runway. So we'll just ask you to keep all of your belongings as close as possible.
That's too big, isn't it?
In conclusion, the basics are implied.
Tiny
in terms of rubbish, jet engines, particularly in rubbish and
damage. What?
Is there a rubbish as well?
Yeah, call me out one too.
If you don't see a bin, hang on to your rubbish and any usable
dragonfly. The big ass dragonfly is too fast.
I'm happy for it. It should really know what to
do. Well, the air show. There is more to this air show than what is.
Can you put the storm, please?
The air show has a tremendous problem.
Open the chicken crimpies.
That the air show since 1992 has had on. The air show on the ground and
there, so look it out.
Is a very, very big story.
It's all up there.
And there's lots of the kids as well. However, if you turn your eyes skyward, you're about to see the skydiving team unfold their canopies.
I'm grateful for the show today.
Wow. That's so cool.
So let's have the jumpers head towards terra firma. The 2023 air show will present from the sky the old parachutes, as you can see, classic brakes, vintage military combatants, global aerobatic champions, and the most advanced modern-day protectors of the skies from America, from Korea, and our own RAAF. Meet the crews that fly them, meet the crews on the standard display line, say hello to them, because they are ready to engage you in conversation.
How cool's that? I should have taken the white brim hat.
Yeah, you should have.
And a quick mention for our children amongst us today, the southern end near the General Aviation Airport area, there's a lot more kiddies to see. Kiddies, forgive me for using that, I'm a bit of an old-fashioned father and I do say kiddies a lot. But, however, there is, for the kids for the first time, pop culture at the show. Check out Pop Culture at the southern end near the circus tent.
Oh, that is so cool.
Bringing cult and quirkiness to the Australian International Air Show. And up that end of the ground, of course, you will find the General Air Sport site where there's all sorts of memorabilia and things to see. Have a look at this picture, though.
Just a quick note too, Peter. It's a great idea to download the Avalon 2023 app onto your smartphone. That will keep you ahead of the flight delay, the full list of everything that's coming up today.
That's awesome.
And a whole bunch of other very important information. So that's the Avalon 2023 app. Peter, right before us, showing precision, almost unmatched precision, parachutists landing on the flare. And showing how easily it's done, some of these jumps have between them, 82,000 jumps.
Incredible. And what about the foreground performance of those who landed on their feet and just continued scrolling as if they were out for a walk in the park? The first two jumpers did exactly that. For those of you at the southern end, I will let you know that you can skid on their backside, which is also a very safe landing for a skydiver. Into wind now, with this sports canopy being juggled, toggled, left and right, and on to feet with a lot of strength, that's right, very safe, and on to his feet, the fourth jumper. What about all round of applause? Up all of these skydivers. These are the men who've done 100 jumps, can you say they've done collectively?
82,000.
82. Ah, jumps.
Just to prove how safe it is, and the aircraft that they jumped out of, yeah. Coming back a little lighter, is the Havilland Turbo Beaver.
So now the stage is set for this, the final day of the Australian International Air Show. Your RAAF will feature very strongly as the course of the day unfolds. And why should they be doing that?
Well, apart from being your Air Force, there is very good reason, because this month, the 21st of March, the Air Force will celebrate 102 years in existence. The RAAF morphed from the Air Flying Corps of World War I.
So,
Air Force is remembering our past.
Do you want to shuffle over a bit? You can take the legs off if you want, or turn them around so that you can sit in my shadow.
I'm sitting in your shadow.
Our evolutionary future.
Oh, check it out.
This is the military and general aviation ground. Demonstrations in the state.
I might just sit
there. Now it's the pilots of the day.
I've lost the... Yeah, I wear sunglasses.
Also, I took the mask off. I couldn't do it. Sorry.
It's only for the crowds.
This isn't the crowd.
Alright, open the chicken crimpies.
Next up on the show, the Romeo helicopter from Navy will return. More on that in just a few moments. One other quick message. With the return with regards to rubbish on the ground, we really do need you to take particular note of any paper or any rubbish that you may
drop good job,
on
Tom.
The ground that you retrieve it and take it with you. Children, hydrate the kids particularly. Stay hydrated yourself.
Stay hydrated today.
Now, that won't sound like a worry ward, but temperatures will rise today to 32 degrees.
A great idea to get in contact with the St. John's Ambulance Service volunteers all over the place. They're bright green overalls. They will be there ready to help you if you're developing any signs of heat stress. Also got tons
tell you what,
sunblock.
This water thing was one of your better ideas.
Like this. So keep an eye out for St. John's. There's also shaded areas to the back and plenty of free water as well.
What? There's what? There's what? Hold it so I'm on the camera. The people... Oh yeah, they left.
How can they trust other people not to take their stuff? I couldn't. I could not.
And just ahead of the early RAAF, well, maybe army trainers, aeroplanes, the train all day in your pilots. Air Force pilots, of course, Navy pilots, they go on to do what they do in the nose of fixed wing aircraft. They're cleared off in just one or two moments. The flyers market, while we do have a moment, for the benefit of those who are chasing some memorabilia or gifts, the flyers market, some of them anywhere near the surface.
Hold this close.
In which way?
Whichever way you think there's a plane. That's the injustice so it stops fucking falling off.
Go ahead.
Let's go now to the early trainers of the Royal Australian Air Force.
There. Oh, yeah.
And we are joined by Flight Lieutenant Brett Milton, the Heritage Squadron of the RAAF. Brett, what do we see?
They're not even coming up.
Wow.
Basically, flying through a simulator or
the fine silt on the perf phone. Put the messenger call, a video call on too for a bit.
Yeah, sure. It's compared to the Tiger, it's very similar, I believe.
Well, call. Just call. He hasn't turned in on the server.
Obviously not as draggy as the Tiger one is.
No, their server still.
150 horsepower, but that's going
to be
charged as well. So it's small. Whereas we made the Tiger one in Australia, we inherited the ride, didn't we, from the Dutch East Indies? Yeah, that's correct. Yeah. And it was used for communications training, I believe. Yes, and maritime patrol, and they've got a fuel tank in the front seat, and flew around, looked for ships, and they landed and bring fuel themselves.
Wow, look at that.
The Tiger one you have flown, can you tell us what that is like? Because
2807. So, don't miss it.
Traditions began at Point Cook, 1914, as the Australian Flying Corps. A
Squadrons 1, 2, 3, and 4. One is still flying. 4 squadron is still up and about. 3 squadron, of course, operating fast jets. So nothing much has really changed in that regard.
I'll leave the airplanes in here.
People, machinery. Did not the Royal Australian Air Force become something else?
Hold tool. Keep an eye out, you have to touch it.
Now, just before the Navy reappear, let's go to the Aerospace News Desk and hear what Alex has got to say.
Two members of Navy top brass recently flew on an exercise aboard Super Hornets to further develop Australia's Air Force and Navy operabilities. Navy Commodores hitched the rides while the aircraft were flying in formation with Super Hornet Growlers, a KC-38 tanker and a PA-8 Poseidon. The Air Warfare Centre Tactics and Training Director at Live Mission demonstrated present and emerging capabilities of Air Force and Navy.
Shoot.
Safety is what it's all about here at the air show. Safety, displaying what we can display, videos turning back the pages of history, and the fast jet movements from around the world. The Koreans are with us. The United States of America and the RAAF will proudly show off all of their kit and hardware in their 1 hour display a little bit later in the day. And there's plenty on the ground in terms of today's evolutionary aircraft on the ground in the static displays.
Where are the glasses?
I can't see anything at all.
Well, David Pison joins us again from Navy. He'll be speaking just very shortly. Tony Moclair, co-commentator of the air show today, is about to introduce the Romeo helicopter.
This is very exciting. The first military aircraft, current military aircraft we're going to see today, joining us through the display, United States Navy Exchange pilot. That would be Lieutenant Casey Callahan and Australian Navy Lieutenant David Pride. Gentlemen, good morning, and what are we seeing to our right?
Yeah, g'day Tony. Looking out to the right, you can see the MH-60 Romeo Seagull, a lean, grey, four-bladed Spectre of Death. The MH-60 Romeo is Australian Navy's only helicopter to operate. It operates in any submarine, any service, and search and rescue dog as well.
Some
of the radar receiving, some of the
so cool.
So we can swing a AZ 114 as well.
That's gross.
And then it's just killing the system. It's a cute, you know, it's like basically a
Actually, I'll just do full HD because not every TV can support 8K.
Oh.
So I'll do full HD, 60 frames per second.
Which way is east?
Huh?
Which way is east?
They should play, honestly, they should play BTS when the Black Eagles come out.
Which way is this?
A little bit late this morning, up close to midday. Well, the world of aerobatics, we're going to show you a lot of that today. And the aerobatics will come in all forms. Aeroplanes from yesteryear, purpose-built aeroplanes to do aerobatics, and the fast jet, the big shakers, the big moves, the boom and zoom. From the RAAF, Korea, and the United States Air Force, you'll be seeing a lot of aerobatics and the showing of some of the latest technology the world can offer. In the world of aerial combat, protectors of the skies.
Lee Brain joins us now for the 4-minute air show. So Lee, great to have you on board. You're about to talk us through what is going to be absolutely zillion. exhilarating display of acrobatics from a master of the art.
That's right, yes, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Glenn Graham, the operations coordinator for the Paul Bennett Air Show. It's beautiful to the runway. You can see a bright yellow, beautiful bright yellow custom biplane known as the Fantastic Drone, which is going to be flown by a man who needs no introduction, none other than Australia's very own Mr. Paul Bennett, who's considered Australia's premier acrobatic air show pilot, who displays all around the country and internationally as well.
Now, we see a lot of monoplane, acrobatic aircraft. Why is Paul gone with biplane?
One simple reason he loves a biplane is it's just sexier than monoplanes. But also, it has a short wingspan, which gives it...
Oh, they must be walking along the way. Yeah, there's smoke. Why you pay the $500 out there.
Okay, the smoke is on. Paul's going to pull him to the top to start with his first figure, which is a spiral dive, which will reach speeds of over 400 kilometers an hour. Not happy with his original position, he's just going to reposition further than the common ground for his.
Where do you go? Oh, there it is.
Set up on the inside.
Unlimited urban I've only got 58% left.
Yeah,
the Black Eagles are next time, so I'm gonna save for the Black Eagles and then Raptors.
Hi,
keep it real, get the job done.
Sit down in front.
So, I got told that there's a barn here, and I wanted to see the barn, so I got a book and some rope, and now I just have to go off this door. Move around.
Next mile.
Yep. Better be good enough for anyone else, too. I'll sort it out.
Thanks for that.
Yeah, no worries, mate.
Catch you next time.
All good, buddy. Have a safe trip.
Thanks, boss.
Everywhere, every time I work.